Welcome everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week I'm going to show you the best sky replacement method I have seen for a very long time, and this is the picture that we are going to do today. I'm also going to do this picture and replace the sky with this picture here. So as usual, let's get started. Let's get rid of what we've got here already and delete that. You can see that in this picture, really great shot of the city, but the sky is just really blown out. So we're gonna match a new sky to the city, and you can see that this picture was probably taken just as the sun was going down, all the lights in the city are coming on. Let's duplicate that layer with the Command J. Let's come over here and grab our new sky, and I chose this sky because of the orange colors in it. So what I'm gonna do is go Command C, come over here to our city and go Command V. Let's just resize that so it fits. We'll drop the opacity on the sky a little bit because what we want to do is just get this sky lined up with the horizon. So just about there looks pretty good. We'll bring the opacity back up. We're going to copy this picture of the sky now with a Command J, and on this layer here, the new sky that we've just copied, we'll come up here to arrange and flip vertical. I'm just going to move that down so it snaps into place on the other sky there. Just move it up a little bit with my arrow keys just so we've got that match, and I'm just going to drag this down to cover the whole picture. Okay, I'm going to select both of these pictures now of the sky. I'm going to come over here to layers and merge selected, so it all merges into one picture. I'm going to change the blend mode on this sky to multiply, and then I'm going to turn that layer off. I'm going to come over here to the background layer of just the city. I'm going to grab my flood selection tool and a tolerance of about 15 or 16, and I'm just going to click on the sky here. We do have a little bit of cleanup to do, so we'll grab our selection brush. Let's make that a little bit bigger. I'm using my Command Plus, and we'll just, holding my Option key down, I'm just going to tidy that up really quickly. Doesn't have to be perfect, but we've got a fairly good selection there. Going to make my brush a little bit smaller just so I can get this antenna in, and also these antennas over here. Just sort of doing this quite quickly. Hold my Option, tidy that up a little bit. Okay, it's looking pretty good. So let's make that a little bit smaller. And I'm going to invert the selection because I want the selection of the city here, not of the sky. So I'm just gonna come up here to my invert. So I wanna invert that selection. And then I'm going to turn my sky layer back on, and I'm going to add a Gaussian blur down here on my live filters. And that Gaussian blur, I'm going to turn all the way up, and it should be blurring the bottom of the picture here, which it has just done. So that's pretty good. So let's get rid of that. Let's get rid of the marching ants with a Command D. And now we're going to add a mask to this layer. So let's add a mask, grab our brush. We want our opacity and flow about 40%, and we want to be painting in black. So now I'm just going to paint in black over the picture down the bottom here. Just get rid of some of that color on the bottom, not all of it, because it's blending really quite nicely all the way down the bottom. Just go over until you're happy, and that is looking pretty good. I'll zoom in so you can just see how well it's blended with the background and the horizon and the sky, and zoom out again a little bit, and I'll just turn that on and off so you can have a look. So that's before and that's after, and that's just with like three easy steps to blend that sky, really done quite quickly. Let's just do one more thing just to make it a little bit better. We'll just add a curve, and we'll just do our S curve. So let's bring that up, let's bring that down, and also I'm just going to bring this one up here just to flatten those blacks out a little bit. So there we go, a really easy quick sky replacement in Affinity Photo, and it also works on a daytime photo as well. So we've got a picture of New York here, and the sky is really, really blown out. So let's do the same again. Command J. Let's come over here to our new sky, which I've picked a nice blue sky. So Command C, over to our city, Command V. Let's move that into position and bring that down till we come right down to the horizon again. About there looks pretty good. Let's copy that layer again up to arrange. range and flip vertically. Bring that layer down until it snaps into place here, and just bring it up a little bit with my arrow key so we can see. There we go, that looks pretty good. Let's select both of those layers again. Layer, merge selected, so it comes into one picture. Let's change the blend mode to multiply. Let's turn that off, come over here to our background. Again, our flood fill selection tool here, about 15 or 16 on tolerance again, and let's click on that. Does a pretty good job. Back to our selection brush, make our brush a little bit bigger, and we're just gonna tidy that up a little bit as well. Just a tiny bit so we can get those bits that we don't want. Tiny little bit of tidy up, and you can see how quick this is. That's a really quick method of replacing the sky. So that looks pretty good. We've got a good selection there. Let's go with that. Let's invert our selection again. So we've just got the city selected. Back on our background and turn it on. Again, let's add a Gaussian blur because we're blurring just the city, not the sky. So let's just blur that out. So we're keeping the sky as it is and blurring all that color on the city. Let's get rid of the marching ants. And again, on our background, let's add a mask. Click on the mask onto our brush. Again, about 40%. This one, not as much. You don't have to do as much on this one because the sky, the blue sky, is really reflecting down on the city here. So it's really just a tiny little bit, and that looks pretty good. So let's have a look. We were here with the blown out sky and with the new sky. Again, I'll zoom in just so you can see how well that has blended with the city and the new sky. Really, really good. So let's drop that down a little bit. Again, if you want to, just to finish off, you don't have to, but we can add that curves layer and do our S curve a little bit up at the top, a little bit down at the bottom, and just flatten those blacks again. I like to do that with a lot of photos, just flatten those blacks out. So there we go, everybody, a really quick method to replace the sky in about 3 steps. So we started with this one, we ended up with this one, come over here to the other one, we started here with the blown out sky, and we finished up here. Okay, if you did enjoy the tutorial this week, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I will say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.